everyone. This is Riya Vishwakarma. I am going to present new shorts weekly updates on income tax, GST and finance dated from 28 July 2021 to 3 August 2021. So let's begin with income tax updates. Regional priority call for candidates nominated for the position of tax assistant at the CBDT through the 2018 combined end of study examination. For the assessment year 2021 to 2022, the tax website is levying a fine of 5,000 rupees for filings that are cleared after July 31. However, many taxpayers are complaining that income tax portal is charging late filing fees even if they have filed in the past few days. During the 2021 pandemic, the state's share of tax divisible pool was the lowest in at least 5 years. And the center's net tax revenue was the highest over the same period. HUF DMAT accounts are on the rise, but the tax structure may not be suitable for most investors. As of June 30, 2021, HUF accounts increased by 1.92 million from 1.79 million 2 years ago. This structure is used by some people to stay within the sub-tax rate range if income spikes could move to higher levels. Moving ahead towards GST updates. Gross goods and services tax revenue collected in July stood at Rs. 1,16,393 crores, indicating a rebound in business activity and the economy in June as states relax restrictions. The Chief Minister of Karnataka, Basavaraj Bommai, stated that the centre agreed to reward the goods and services tax compensation that was not paid last year. The installment payment is at least Rs. 11,400 crores. GSTIN enables new features for taxpayers to verify and update bank account details on government portals through non-basic amendment. CBIC has added new functionality on AATO annual aggregate turnover for taxpayers on the government official GSTN portal. CBIC notifies removal of mandatory audit by CACMA under GST. Moving towards finance updates, cryptocurrency trading platform Binance had announced to launch tax reporting tool, a new API that will enable Binance users to easily keep track of their crypto activities and streamline reporting requirements. SEBI on Friday extended timelines for compliance with certain regulatory requirements by stock brokers, clearing members and KYC registration agencies in view of the coronavirus pandemic till September 30th. Ministry of Corporate Affairs claims that spending of funds for COVID-19 vaccinations for persons other than the employees and their families is an eligible CSR. Corporate Social Responsibility Activity. To help all stakeholders in the COVID fight, RBI Governor Shaktikant Das announced on an on-tap liquidity facility of Rs. 50,000 crores to ease access to healthcare services. PM Modi launches digital payment solution e-Rupee. E-Rupee vouchers will initially be available for health services. For further updates, you can also follow us on our social media handles as displayed above. Also, drop in your email address in the comment section below to receive our weekly news shorts personally in your mailbox.